Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 18.1 Beta 1. This update brings us previews of what's coming after the public release of iOS 18 and includes Apple Intelligence. This update is only available for the iPhone 15 Pro and 15 Pro Max so far, and it also says Apple Intelligence is not currently available in the EU or China. To try out Apple Intelligence, you'll have to join the waitlist and settings. I'll show you that in a moment. It's actually account-wide, so once it's approved on your iPhone, it will carry over to the iPad. And both devices' languages and Siri language must be set to US English, and the device region must be set to the United States. So this brings all of the Apple Intelligence features early on to try them out. Now, the overall size wasn't that big at 637.5 megabytes, and it was also released alongside iPadOS 18.1 Beta 1 and macOS 15.1 Sequoia Beta 1. All of those are out, so you can try out the updates with Apple Intelligence on supported devices. Apple also released iOS 18 Public Beta 2 for both iOS and iPad. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings. Then we'll go to General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 22B5007P. This gives us a preview of Apple Intelligence, but there are some bugs and issues with it. But if we go to the main settings page and scroll down, you'll see Apple Intelligence and Siri. The first time you go into this, you'll actually have a button to join the waitlist. Once you've actually joined and it's brought everything in, it will actually start downloading information for it and then install it and then let you in and sort of give you a pop-up showing welcome to Apple Intelligence. And this is what the splash screens for Apple Intelligence look like. New tools to express yourself, a new era for Siri, groundbreaking privacy. Then it lets you in, and you can see the waitlist here where it said it was waitlisted and support for processing is downloading. So you'll see that's what it looks like, and then you can get in and it tells you about Siri and more. Now, if we go into our settings again, we have all the same settings we do with Siri, but we also have additional settings at the bottom that say Apple Intelligence and Siri app access. But before I show you the new Siri, there's actually call recording in this update. If we go into the phone app, and you'll see we're at Apple Computer, maybe I'll just call here. Give it just a moment. And in the upper left, we have what looks like the voice memos option. Tap on it. It'll say this call will be recorded. The audio prompt plays and then begins recording the call. So now it's recording. It says take notes on this call. So it's putting it right into notes, and you'll see it's actually recording the call overall. So we can go back in and listen to it. So if I stop the call or stop the recording, we'll stop the call, and then we can view the saved call here, and it says call with Apple. So if we go into it, you can see different information here. We have a summary of it with Apple Intelligence, so we'll give it just a moment here to try and summarize it. It may or may not work well yet, and some of these features take a while to show up. And the summary didn't really do anything. It wasn't that long of a call, so maybe that's something that's not working properly yet. But you'll see we have the transcription options here. We can play back the call, see what it looks like, and that just gives you an idea of how it works. Now, it looks like, based off of this information, it may not be on older versions of iOS. So it looks like it's here. Maybe only Apple Intelligence includes this. Now, when it comes to the new Siri, we can actually use the keyword or just press and hold, and you'll see the new animation. It looks great, and it also sounds great. Let me turn up the volume here so you can hear it. One more time. That's what it looks like. Now, Siri hasn't improved at all as far as its intelligence. Not yet. That may be coming later, but what's the weather tomorrow?
Expect rain tomorrow.
So it looks like it's the same exact Siri, just with a new animation so far. So it looks great. There's also a way to type to Siri by double tapping the bottom. So if we double tap the bottom, you'll see that we get a little icon here, but it doesn't bring up the keyboard just yet. There is a way to get this to activate though. If you go into Settings, then we go to Accessibility, then we go down to Siri, under Siri, then we have Type to Siri. If this is enabled and we press and hold, we can then type to Siri. What is the weather tomorrow? And we'll get the same thing, but we can type to Siri and it gives that information. Now, unfortunately, when that's activated, it will go to type to Siri every time now if that's activated. So there's definitely a little bug there. And now if we go back in, you'll see what it looks like. So it looks great and it's working well, but again, it's not the new Siri just yet. Now there's context-aware replies with messages. If we go into messages, you'll see here there's suggestions where they use Apple Intelligence. And so I asked a question from a different phone. I heard that Apple Intelligence is out. What do you think of it? Is it any good? Should I install it? Will it work on 15 Pro Max? And you'll see it actually said it should work on all models, which isn't correct. So we can provide feedback and say that there's a problem there. So that's something they've updated. Let's go back here. And then you'll see it sort of highlights them so you can see that there's AI replies. Also, one other thing worth noting is they've switched back the actual menu for emoji to what it was before. So we have our different stickers here and the enlarged emoji here as well. You'll see I have a conversation with Brahm, and if I press and hold and maybe select all, then I have writing tools options. Not only that, but we have the same icon down here. Tap on it, we get our writing tools options, and maybe we'll make it more friendly. It gives it a second, and now it says, it's a bit disappointing that Apple's intelligence isn't available on iOS 18 for everyone. So we can go back to the original. We can actually share feedback. So we go to the original. We can maybe retry here. See what it does. And now it says it's a bit frustrating that Apple's intelligence isn't available on iOS 18 for everyone. So you have all of these options to use these writing tools. It also works with proofread. So tap on proofread. It says no recommended changes. If we go back, if we go into notes, maybe select some text here. So we'll select maybe all of it. And then we can go to our AI tools with proofread or rewrite. So we've got those options here. We'll proofread. It found some changes, you'll see here, and it underlines them and then sort of has fading gradient colors going between the underlines. So it's suggesting some changes there and shows you what you could change. You don't have to, you can switch back to the original, but I think this should be a really nice feature in the future. I'm looking forward to using this once it's complete. Now, if we go into our focus modes, there's an update here as well. This also seems to somewhat be on the public beta this time with public beta 2. If we go into settings, and then we go into our focus mode. So we'll go here under focus. We now have an option to reduce interruptions using AI. So if we go into this, it says intelligence breakthrough and silencing. When reduce interruptions is active, intelligently allow important notifications to interrupt you and silence notifications determined not to be important. Any notifications specifically allowed or silenced will always be allowed or silenced. So you can turn this on. And if we go into the 14 Pro Max here that I have, and we go to our focus modes, you'll see that we have reduce interruptions here. But it doesn't seem to be the same thing with Apple Intelligence, as we don't have the menu for that if we go into settings with public beta 2. But if we go into focus, you'll see that we have reduce interruptions, and it's a little bit different as it doesn't have the intelligence breakthrough part. So that's something that's been updated with iOS 18.1 beta 1 in Apple Intelligence. Mail also gets some updates here as well. Within Mail, we now have a summarize button. So if we tap on summarize, it will look through the email, and this is an older one, but it will look through the email and now tell you exactly what the email says in a summary. It's a little bit buggy, doesn't seem to be great, but it's still actually working. So this is something that's probably going to improve over time. Also, if we go back to the main mailbox, within one of my mailboxes, you'll see up here in the upper right, tap on the three dots, and now it has an option to show priority. So you can turn that on or off in your main mailbox or in your group mailboxes as well. Additionally, if we go into settings, scroll down to privacy and security, then go all the way to the bottom under transparency logs, we now have new logs for Apple Intelligence Report. If we tap on this, it verifies with Face ID or your passcode. And then you'll see it says report duration and export activity. And it says this report may include personal data such as messages and text you enter in intelligent writing tools. So that's something that's on device only. And if we go back, you'll see that's the only option for it. So that's been updated for Apple Intelligence. One thing we don't have though is Genmoji just yet. So it seems to be lacking in a few different areas. Siri 2.0 isn't here. Just the overall animation is here, just not the actual intelligent part, along with ChatGPT. I haven't seen that as well yet. In settings under general and then iPhone storage, we can scroll to the bottom, go to iOS, and see how much data Apple Intelligence is taking up so far as well. So almost 3 gigabytes, 2.87 gigabytes. So it's a fairly large install. This will probably grow over time. Now, as far as any additional bugs or anything going on here, well, I haven't noticed much of a change as far as that goes. I'm sure there's some things that are probably fixed in here, but I haven't noticed anything different. As far as maybe changing the backgrounds or anything like that, it seems to basically be the same with customize, switch between light and dark mode, automatic, tinted, go back to dark mode. It's basically everything the same. It's even lacking the iPhone 15 wallpaper. So if we go in and then we add a new one, you'll see as I scroll down, the latest iPhone 15 Pro wallpaper is just not here. So those bugs that were in iOS 18 Beta 4 still remain here. As far as security updates or anything else, Apple hasn't mentioned. And as far as actual release notes, well, last time I checked, there wasn't anything, but let's check now just before we continue. And of course, they've just updated them. So they only have two things in here under general. It says, see the iOS and iPadOS Beta 4 release notes for additional details about new features, resolved issues, known issues, and deprecations. And then they've added the new feature of Apple Intelligence. So basically, this is probably Beta 4 with Apple Intelligence enabled. So it seems like it's got all of the same bugs of iOS 18 Beta 4 and public Beta 2. Now, as far as performance, well, it feels the same as Beta 4 so far. The phone feels basically the same, scrolling, ProMotion, everything else. And I've shown you some issues here and there with iOS, with Apple Intelligence. So definitely some odd bugs going on, but performance seems to be okay. And as far as the heat, well, it's definitely getting quite hot processing all of this AI information. I would imagine it's going to stay that way for a little while. As far as battery life, if we go up to battery and then battery health, I'm down to 92% with 260 cycles. And if we go back to the last 10 days, and you'll see yesterday, I had 2 hours and 20 minutes of screen active time, 3 hours and 39 minutes of screen idle time, and used about 60 to 70% of my battery. Today, so far, 2 hours and 34 minutes. And I'm still not seeing the update where it's telling me it's processing in the background, but that's something some people are seeing, just telling you that it's going to sort of use a lot of your power and possibly cause the device to heat up. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 18.1 Beta 1, I probably would hold off, especially if you're not in the US and not a developer trying this out. However, if you're wondering about iOS 18 Public Beta 2, that one I would say is probably stable enough. That's similar to Beta 4. It still is going to have bugs. You'll need to report those in feedback. But in general, it's much better than earlier iOS 17 betas, but it still has a ways to go. As far as when to expect the next betas, well, at this point, maybe we'll see them next week, next Monday or Tuesday. We should be on a weekly schedule, so maybe we'll see iOS 18 Beta 5, Public Beta 3, and maybe even iOS 18.1 Beta 2, but we don't really know yet. Apple hasn't clarified any of that, and there's a ton of different things to come out yet. iOS 17.6 is also still in the works and should be coming out very soon. Of course, I expect the iOS 18 public release sometime in mid-September around the iPhone 16 launch, and iOS 18.1 public release sometime in mid-October at this point. That's typically what Apple does every year. As far as benchmarks, I did run them, but it's processing so much in the background that it probably doesn't matter yet. But you'll see it scored 2,689 for single core, 6,314 for multi-core. It's even lower than the previous time I ran it on iOS 18 Beta 4, so definitely a lot going on here. And we'll check this out on the weekend and see if it's improved at all in the weekend follow-up. If you found anything else in iOS 18.1 Beta 1 or iOS 18 Public Beta 2, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.